Chapter 9, From the Short to the Medium Run, the ISLM-PC Model. Chapter 9 Outline, From the Short to the Medium Run, the ISLM-PC Model. 9-1, the ISLM-PC Model. 9-2, Dynamics and the Medium Run Equilibrium. 9-3, Fiscal Consolidation Revisited. 9-4, The Effects of an Increase in the Price of Oil. 9-5, Conclusions. In chapters 3 through 6, we looked at equilibrium in the goods and financial markets and how output is determined in the short run. In chapters 7 and 8, we looked at equilibrium in the labor market. We now put the two parts together and use this ISLM-PC, PC for Phillips curve, model to characterize the behavior of output both in the short run and the medium run. Equation 9.1 for the IS curve shows equilibrium in the short run is determined by demand. To go from the short run to the medium run, we need to understand the relation between unemployment and inflation as given by the Phillips curve and shown in equation 9.2. The IS curve has output Y on the horizontal axis. We now try to restate the Phillips curve in terms of the relation between change in inflation and the output gap. To derive that, start by understanding that the unemployment rate U equals U over L, where uppercase U is the number unemployed and L is the labor force. Next, since L equals U plus N, where N is the number employed, U equals L minus N. Thus, U equals L minus N and the difference divided by L, or 1 minus N over L, which gives us N over L equals 1 minus U, or N equals L times 1 minus U. Since Y equals N, Y also equals L times 1 minus U. NN indicates the natural rate of employment. YN indicates potential output. Output gap is the difference between actual output Y and potential output YN and is equal to minus L times U minus UN. Equation 9.3 restates the Phillips curve as a relation between change in inflation and the output gap. Assume wage setters expect inflation this year, pi, to be the same as last year, indicated by pi minus 1. Then equation 9.4 says, when output is above potential, positive output gap, inflation increases and vice versa. 9-1. The ISLM-PC model. Figure 9-1 shows equilibrium in the short run and medium run. Short run equilibrium is shown in the top graph at point A using the ISLM model. A low policy rate leads to higher output. Bottom graph depicts the upward sloping Phillips curve with output on the x-axis and change in inflation rate on the y-axis. It shows a positive output gap when actual output Y in the short run is above the natural output YN. This will cause change in inflation to be positive as seen at point A on the Phillips curve. Focus: Okun's law across time and countries. Adjustment from the short run to the medium run equilibrium happens through the working of the labor market. Okun's law is an empirical relationship observed between change in the unemployment rate versus output growth in the United States 1960 to 2014. Figure 1 shows high output growth is associated with a reduction in the unemployment rate. Low growth, below 3%, is associated with an increase in the unemployment rate. Focus: Okun's law across time and countries. Equation 9b.1 says Okun's law can be written as the change in the unemployment rate that is approximately equal to the negative of the growth rate of output. Equation 9b.2 shows the regression line that fits the points in figure 1. According to this, annual output growth has to be at least 3% to prevent the unemployment rate from rising. Output growth 1% above normal leads only to a 0.4% reduction in the unemployment rate due to such factors as labor hoarding and discouraged workers. The coefficient 0.4 is called the Okun coefficient. Figure 9-2 illustrates the dynamics involved in medium-run equilibrium. The top graph shows the short-run equilibrium at point A. The bottom graph shows that the output corresponding to that Y would be above the potential output Yn. Economy would be at point A on the Phillips curve, where change in inflation would be positive. The Fed would step in at that point and raise the nominal interest rate with the goal of raising the real interest rate to Rn. The economy will move along the IS curve in the top graph till it reaches A prime, where Y equals Yn. This represents medium run equilibrium. Economy is at potential output and change in inflation is zero, inflation is stable. However, in this case, since our assumption is that change in inflation is the difference in inflation this year minus its level last year, as the economy is moving from A to A prime, change in inflation is positive and the level of inflation would be getting higher. If at A prime, the inflation rate is higher than what the Fed wants, the Fed may have to push the economy to point C and the economy in a recession before it lowers the rate back to Rn and the economy settles at A prime in the medium run. Rn is called the natural, neutral, or Wechselian rate of interest. It is the rate at which the economy is at the potential level of output. 9-2. Dynamics and the medium run equilibrium. Equation 9.5 shows the Phillips curve equation if we assume that expected inflation rate is constant, so a positive output graph generates a higher level of inflation rather than an increase in inflation. So long as inflation expectations remain anchored, the central bank does not need to compensate for the initial boom by a recession later. Figure 9-3 shows the dangers of a deflation spiral. Suppose economy is at point A in the short run at output level Y, which is below the potential level of output. In this case, the Phillips curve tells us that the change in inflation will be negative. In this case, if the Fed lowers the nominal interest rate, but the zero lower bound prevents the real rate from falling to a level needed to restore potential output, in this case, deflationary spiral will kick in. Falling prices will cause real interest rate to go up and output to fall further and more deflation. The zero lower bound constraint may make it impossible to achieve a negative real policy rate. Deflation spiral or deflation trap occurs at Y prime, figure 9-3, when output is still below potential and thus inflation is still decreasing. Lower output leads to more deflation, and more deflation leads to a higher real interest rate and lower output. Focus: deflation in the Great Depression. Table 1 shows the economy seemed to be in a deflation trap between 1929 and 1933. Monetary policy decreased the nominal interest rate from 5.3% to 2.3% in 1933. But with negative inflation rates, the real rate reached 12.3% in 1931 and 7.8% in 1933. 9-3. Fiscal consolidation revisited. Figure 9-4 shows the impact of fiscal consolidation in the short run and the medium run. Top graph shows the IS curve shifts left as a result of contractionary fiscal policy, causing output to fall from Yn to Y prime and investment to fall, since investment depends on output and the interest rate and output is lower. However, as a result of the fall in output to below potential, change in inflation will be negative. The Fed will step in by lowering the nominal rate with the goal of lowering the real policy rate. LM will shift down till output returns to potential level. Investment will increase in the medium run since output has returned to its previous level while real interest rate is lower. 9-4. The effects of an increase in the price of oil. Figure 9-5 shows the change in the nominal and real price of oil. Over the last 40 years, there have been two sharp increases in the real price of oil, the first in the 1970s and the second in the 2000s. 9-4. The effects of an increase in the price of oil. 1970s, OPEC, the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, act as a monopoly and increased oil prices. 2000s, The fast growth of emerging economies led to a rapid increase in world oil demand and thus a steady increase in real oil prices. 2008, a large recession led to a sudden decrease in the demand for oil and thus falling oil prices. 2014 and after, a combination of increased supply due to the increase in U.S. shale oil production and the partial breakdown of OPEC led to a sudden drop in oil prices. Figure 9-6 shows the effects of an increase in the price of oil on the natural rate of unemployment. An increase in the price of oil is equivalent to an increase in the markup. It leads to a downward shift of the price setting curve. Real wages are lower, and the natural rate of unemployment given by the intersection of the wage setting and price setting curve is higher. Figure 9-7 shows the short and medium run effects of an increase in the price of oil. Increase in the price of oil shifts the Phillips curve upward. Change in inflation becomes positive. The Fed raises rates to curb inflationary pressures. This causes LM curve to shift up in the top graph. Economy moves from point A to A prime in the short run to A double prime in the medium run. Natural or neutral rate of interest is higher and the potential level of output is lower in the medium run. Economy suffers from stagflation, lower output and higher inflation along the way. Focus: oil price increases. Why were the 2000s so different from the 1970s? Figure 1 shows the effects of an increase in the price of oil on output and the price level are smaller than they used to be. Plausible explanations include workers' lower bargaining power and inflation that was more anchored by monetary policy. 9-5 Conclusions. Shocks or changes in policy typically have different effects in the short run and in the medium run. Disagreements about the effects of various policies depend on how fast you think the economy adjusts to shocks. Movements in output around its trend are called output fluctuations, business cycles. Economic fluctuations are the results of shocks and their dynamic effects called the propagation mechanism.